Financial advisor. That's the title, right? That's my title. Why do I spend so much time talking about everything else outside of money? I spend a lot of my video time talking about mindset. I talk a lot about family and life and lessons and wisdom and things that I've learned. Why? Why is it that a financial advisor just isn't on here telling you about how to invest your money? It's pretty simple. Because in the two decades that I've been doing what I do, I've recognized year after year after year that the most important thing, the most successful people, the most invigorating idea that keeps coming up over and over again is that it's not about the money. If it's all about the money, then we've completely missed the point. And so now, is money important? It absolutely is. Do I have to be very good at that part of the job? Absolutely. But here's the key. This is what it means when I'm talking about the difference. Our mindset, our ability to choose the right path, to choose the right response, to not react at the wrong time, the mindset that we have with our family and what we're working for. What are we working towards? Why are we working towards it? Those are the very things that make financial advisors actually important parts of your life. Because I learned a long time ago, especially growing up in the early 2000s, that markets go up and down. Your self-worth as an advisor can go up and down to your clients. But if you can help them have better relationships, if you can help them find the things that matter most to them in their lives, if you can listen better than oftentimes us as couples are able to do one-on-one and find the gold that exists between their message, you can do things that help change people's lives. You can help them find the things that make life the most important part and wealth secondary. It's why we call our process life and wealth optimization. What does it mean to have life and wealth optimization? Well, it all starts with life. So oftentimes people will call and they'll say, Scott, we want you to help us with our money. And I'll start asking them all these questions that have nothing to do with their money. And first thing I'm doing is qualifying to make sure that they're the type of people that we can have a great relationship with. Because it all begins with a relationship. It all begins with something that is very simple. Do we like each other? Can we get along? Do I see what you're trying to tell me is a goal or an objective? Can I help you get there? I don't want to take a job that I can't help you do. I want to make sure I can understand what your goals and objectives are, right? And so my first questions are all about life. Tell me about your family. Tell me about the kids. Tell me about your parents. Tell me about what your parents did. I'm trying to gain access to exactly what are some of the things that make you click when it comes to financial decisions. What are the things that shaped you into who you are today? Why is it so important for you to have this? Are we trying to have goals towards stuff, or are we trying to have goals towards dreams? There's a great book by Matthew Kelly called Dream Manager, and it's an awesome book, and it talks all about how when you really get to the bottom of what people are working towards and you're helping them find what matters most to them, you're really helping people navigate their dreams. And it comes at it from a corporate perspective where you're helping your employees or your workmates or teammates actually reach their dreams, not just a job. If you work somewhere and it's so much more important than just a job, then all of a sudden, you really want to be there. You really love what you do. Well, the same thing applies for what we do. A financial advisor is just the title. A good coach or financial advisor or consultant or planner or whatever you want to call them helps make you think differently. They help guide the conversation towards the very things that you're often afraid to talk about at the dinner table. I've been in this office, this same conference room, many a times. And husbands and wives and couples in general will have a challenging conversation. We'll broach some subjects that make them uncomfortable. I'll watch the fear or the frustration or the tiptoeing around, not saying the wrong thing, not going down this path. And guess what? I'm going down that path. I'm going to find out why, how, what. What are the things that help us get there and overcome this negative loop that we often find ourselves in? Because if I'm trying to help you reach your goals, dreams, and objectives, I got to know the whole story. What's your story? What does freedom mean to you is a question we always ask, but it means something different to everybody. You know, where do you see yourself in 5 or 10 years is not something that, it's not a job application. I'm not asking because I want to know that you're going to be successful in working for our company. I'm asking because I want to help you clearly define what it is that matters most to you. And so when a financial advisor is talking about things like coaching, like family, like gratitude, these are pie in the sky things that a lot of people may not understand the connectivity. They're all connected. They're absolutely more connected than you know. My most successful clients are the people that are most dialed in right here, right up here, and right here. They know what's most important to them. They put their heart and their love in the things that matter most. They put their mind around getting to those things. They really make love the priority, life the priority, and money just helps them get to that path. So when we start talking about these topics, and you ask yourself, what gives Scott the ability to provide me data on these things? Why should I listen to me? Right? Why should you listen to me? I get that question, and I understand not everybody will, but I can tell you this. In a couple decades of sitting in an office like this with multiple meetings a day, you get the experience of something that so few people see. Money brings out the best and worst in us. It brings out the best and worst in us. It really puts us in a position on a regular basis where when we talk about it, some people hide everything there is about money. They're ashamed of what they have or what they don't have. They compare themselves to other people, their neighbors, their friends, their family members. One brother or one sister is more successful than another, and they always feel a level of shame. I see it. I feel it. I talk about it in my office. These are the types of things that go beyond just financial advice. It's not about just managing a portfolio. If that's all the financial advisor is doing, that's never been my job. That's never been what I call my role. I've always said that I'm a life coach that specializes in money, and I do a couple of big things. Number one is investment management. We help people know where to go. Number two is scenario planning. You know, if this, then that. The planning portion. How do we get there? If we do this, this is how we get there. And number three is vision coaching. What is it specifically that you see yourself doing? You know how many people come into our office and they want to retire and you ask them what they're going to do and they have no clue? Their only impact in their brain at the time, their only impact in their life has been their career and their job. And they're scared. They're petrified about where this path may take them. We have to coach them. We have to pull some things out. What specifically do you want to do every day when you stop working? What specifically are you going to get involved in? What community organizations have you been engaged and involved in for years that you wish you could do more, but you couldn't because you were working? Do you love golfing? Do you love traveling? Where have you always dreamed of seeing? What did you want to be when you grow up? That's a great question. Most people don't know that that's a great question that leads people to nostalgia. It leads people to remember. I've heard things like, I wanted to be a ballerina, and the husband looks at the wife and goes, I never even knew that. And she starts talking about how much she loves ballet. And before the end of the appointment, they're going to a ballet together, something the husband swore he'd never do. But when he saw his wife light up when she told me, it mattered to him. And the same thing applies the other way. I've had 55 to 60 year old clients in here, and one says, oh, I can't wait to move to our property in the mountains. And the wife looks at him and says, we're not leaving our grandbabies. And they're completely on opposite sides of the coin. They are nowhere near each other. And they both have been driving towards the same goal of retiring and no longer working. And they're completely in opposite directions. We help them find common ground. We help them find the ways to make that work. And so, you know, why is it that that provides any level of value to you? Here's the key. I'm learning every day. I'm listening every day. I'm learning from every one of these scenarios to get better at advising the very people that come to me and entrust their future with me. But they're not coming to me just for money. If they're coming to me just for money, they're only getting a very, very small portion of what I can help them with in their lives. And I'm going to keep learning and keep listening and keep growing so I can continue to get better at this craft, which is titled financial advice, but it's really all about helping and coaching people to be and do the very things they dreamed of doing their entire lives. And how money fits into that equation. Money secondary. Life, then wealth. If we can focus on life and then wealth, we can optimize the future. And so that's why I spend so much time talking about mindset. That's why I spend so much time trying to take you on a path of something that you may not understand is so important today, but in the couple of decades of doing this, I can assure you that having your heart and your mind in the right place, your money just works. It just does the right things. Great things happen for people that are grounded mentally and emotionally. And when they're not being yanked around by emotional reactions, and they're not mentally looping into all these different ideas, and they're focused, it's a lot more success is had. I'm Scott Danner with Freedom Street Partners, telling you today why financial advice is so much more than just about money. Mindset beats money all day long, because without the right mindset, money is quick and fleeting. So I would encourage you today to tell me, what is it that you've done in your life that shifted your mindset to make you more successful? What are some of the things you've done mentally to prepare you to be more financially successful? What are the things that you've done in your life that have nothing to do with money, but have yielded you the best returns? Help me understand and learn. Help me teach somebody else your lesson.